So can anyone tell what points we have seen in the previous lecture? This is our second lecture. So what points we have seen in the previous lecture? Can you tell? Yes. My screen is visible to everyone. Hello. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Give response. Otherwise, I am not able to understand. Okay. Screen is visible. I will maximize it. So, can you tell what points we have seen in the previous lecture? What points are covered in the last lecture? Give the answers.
What point? Vision, mission, and syllabus discussed.
What? Syllabus we have discussed. So we have seen the basic concept of business ethics. We have discussed the syllabus, and then we have seen the title of subject, central idea of the subject, importance of the subject. That points we have covered in the previous lecture. Okay, so I will just repeat that points. So we have seen you just excuse me for 1 minute. Just if there is any problem or net issue in between, you can reply me immediately. Now screen is visible properly to everyone. Yes, give the answer. Shreya?
Not visible, ma'am.
Not visible. Okay, so I will share it once again. Okay, now it is visible.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So that's why again it is creating disturbance to admit the students in between. So that's why I have asked you to join in time so that it will not have any disturbance. Okay. So at least take care hereafter from next lecture. Join the lecture in time. Okay. So we have discussed this vision, mission statement. After that, we have seen the syllabus. So there are total 6 chapters in the syllabus. So that points we have discussed. Introduction ahe pahila chapter. Then next one is decision and management of business ethics. Third chapter is framing the business ethics. How to frame the policies of business ethics. That is the third chapter. Then fourth, it is employees, consumers, and business ethics. Then next is civil society and environment. How the civil society and environment, that things are affecting on forming the business ethics. That points we have discussed. So can anyone tell some example about this particular point? सिव्हिल सोसायटी अँड एन्व्हायरमेंट ह्याचा बिझनेस इथिक्सशी कसा संबंध आहे सांगू शकताय कोणी आन्सर? येस, हाऊ दिस बिझनेस इथिक्स इज रिलेटेड विथ दिस टू पॉइंट्स सिव्हिल सोसायटी अँड एन्व्हायरमेंट. सो ट्राय टू गिव्ह द आन्सर ऑर गिव्ह सम एक्झाम्पल ऑफ दिस पॉइंट, हाऊ दिस सिव्हिल सोसायटी अँड एन्व्हायरमेंट इज रिलेटेड टू इच अदर. Or how this civil society and environment is related to the business ethics. Try to give some example of this. Yes, Vaishnavi. Are you getting the question? Are you able to hear what I am asking? Ashwini, Ashwini More is there?
Yes, ma'am.
So what question I am asking here? Try to give the example of how this civil society and environment that is related with business ethics. Environment cha kai effect hoto ka business ethics policies madhe? You tell me first, tyacha kai effect hoto ka? Others can also give the answers. Shreya, yes,
environmental aspect.
No, your voice is not audible, Srishti. Range problem is there or what? You just check, your voice is not audible. Shreya is there? Shreya Kulkarni. So I have asked the question here. Give me one example that how the civil society and environment that is affecting on business ethics. Kai effect hoto ka adhi mala sanga civil society and environment sa business ethics policies varti. Whether that two things are related with business ethics.
Ma'am, mi atta join zali lecture, thoda range issue hota manun.
Okay, okay. So anybody else? And attendance is very less.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes. तुम्हाला लेक्चर दोन वाजता
सांगितलं.
नाही मला सांगा आधी, तुम्हाला लेक्चर दोन वाजताच आहे ना ऍज युजल, सो वाय दिस मच अटेंडन्स टुडे, व्हेरी लेस अटेंडन्स इज देअर. ओके, यू कॅन गिव्ह द आन्सर. हा, हु वॉज गिव्हिंग द आन्सर?
एन्व्हायरमेंटल फॅक्टर्स अफेक्ट्स सिव्हिल सोसायटी ऑर्गनायझेशन.
Yes, Srushti. Okay, so environment and civil society has a business ethics what the effect hoto. So for example, if you are starting your particular business, that will definitely affect on forming the business ethics policies. Tumhi jar ata ekada area ahe jitha where very rich people are there, there if you are starting your products, definitely that business ethics for that particular area or that particular business will be different. If you are starting it in a rural region, then the business ethics policies will be different. That's why in every country, if you see, business ethics policies are also different. So as the points will come in the upcoming chapters, we will see the various example also. आता आपल्या इथे जे business ethics आहेत, that is not same in case of America. So based on the civil society, the society kutli ahe, what is their economical range, what is their literacy level, all these parameters will definitely affect on the business, and as well as they are going to affect on the business ethics policies. Environment sudha in which environment that business is being developed, that will also impact on formation of the business ethics. So this syllabus point we have discussed in the previous lecture. Then we have seen this about title of chapter, about title of subject, central idea of subject. Next, we have seen the importance of subject. So this is about title of course. So can anyone define business ethics? Yes, just for my confirmation, how much you have understood, how we can define business ethics? What is the definition of business ethics? Give the answer. Business ethics means what? Sandesh, can you tell what is the meaning of business ethics? How we define business ethics? See, if I am asking the question and you are not responding, I am going to mark your absentee. Keep that things in mind. This is not for reducing your attendance, but for making you alert during the lecture and attentive. Yes, who will define business ethics? Last lecture we have seen.
Professional and ethical principles that we have been set up for setting the business.
एखादा business करत असताना त्यामधल्या stakeholders ना जे काही moral values किंवा moral principles follow करावे लागतात. That well-defined set of that moral values and standards, that is called as the business ethics. So there are some rules that should be followed, that is called as the business ethics. So that is basic point. And as this subject is new, some points are very new to you because you have not studied. Some subject was there, you were telling, but as compared with other subjects, you will come across various new terms in this subject. So you pay attention properly for the lecture. That is my request. Okay. So business ethics definition we have seen, title of course. Then next point we have seen about central idea of the subject. So in this chapter wise we have seen what is there in the each chapter. Pratyek chapter madhe kay bagayche aplyala, that points we have discussed in the previous lecture. And objective outcomes, that also we have seen. Importance of the course, that also we have discussed. To act as an entrepreneur as well as to act as an employee, you should be familiar with terms of this business ethics and policies of this business ethics. That is about importance of this course. Then we have seen objective and outcomes. So have we discussed objective and outcomes in the last lecture? Course objective and outcomes, whether we have discussed or not?
Yes ma'am, we discussed.
Okay, so after discussion of these initial points, today we will start with this chapter number 1. Okay, so you pay attention properly for all the basic points. So first chapter ahe, introduction of business ethics. So first chapter, it has the points which are having the introduction of basic concept of business ethics. So here is the syllabus for business ethics. See here, the syllabus points are, so first chapter, unit number 1, introduction of business ethics. Syllabus is business ethics and overview and importance of business ethics. Ya chapter madhe pahilyanda aplyala kay bagayche, whatever we have discussed, the basic concept, business ethics means what, that first we have to revise. and then we have to see what is importance of business ethics, why this business ethics is required. So generally we have discussed why this business ethics is required, but in this chapter, whatever is this point, importance of business ethics with respect to 10 points, the importance of business ethics has been explained. म्हणजे technically कुठल्या points through upon importance of business ethics discuss करणार आहोत, that points are there in this chapter. Okay, then we have to study about globalization, sustainability, आणि last point आहे ethical theories. So there are two types of ethical theories, normative ethical theories and contemporary ethical theories. So that points we have to see in this particular chapter. Okay, now so about title of the chapter, so as we know that introduction means what, it is giving the basic idea. Mata itha ya chapter madhe ka bagaycha apnala, introduction of business ethics. So the introduction of business ethics, it gives the basic knowledge about business ethics and why it is important in the organization or any business. In this context, ethical theories is the key objective that you are studying in this chapter for the first time. मग ज्या काही ethical theories आहेत त्या ethical theories important आहेत, because by considering that ethical theories itself, these business ethics documents are formed. Okay, so this is about the title of the chapter. The next central idea of the chapter, it is this chapter provides information about business ethics, morality, ethical laws, and also gives brief knowledge about the ethical theories and why business ethics is important in the organization. So this is about central idea of the chapter. Then importance of this chapter, why this chapter is important in your syllabus, you only tell me now. Now why this chapter is important in your syllabus? I expect the answers from you, otherwise it is only one-sided lecture. That should not be there. काय इम्पॉर्टंट आहे हा चॅप्टर सिलेबस मध्ये सांगा तुमच्या. यस ओंकार, कॅन यू गिव द आन्सर? ओंकार जिंगाडे, वाय दिस चॅप्टर इज इम्पॉर्टंट इन युअर सिलेबस? ओंकार?
यस मॅम.
वाय दिस फर्स्ट चॅप्टर इज इम्पॉर्टंट? काय बघायचं सांगितलं या चॅप्टर मध्ये मी? व्हॉट आय टोल्ड व्हॉट वी हॅव टू सी इन दिस चॅप्टर?
दॅट गिव्स द बेसिक आयडिया ऑफ द होल द सब्जेक्ट.
सो हियर इज द बेसिक कन्सेप्ट ऑफ बिझनेस इथिक्स and basic introductory parts are there in this chapter number 1. That's why if you are not understanding it, the basic concepts properly, you will it will be difficult to understand the next chapters. So this chapter gives brief knowledge to students about business ethics, morality, ethical theories and why ethics is important in the organization. That's why this chapter is important. Okay, so now we will start. Then the next point, it is chapter objective and outcomes. So at the end of chapter, what you should be able to understand? So at the end of the chapter, you should be able to understand the ethical theories and why the business ethics is important in the organization. Teen points madhe apan ya chapter la divide karu shakto. Baga ekda ajun pahilyanda aplyala overview bagaycha aahe. And what is importance of business ethics, why this business ethics is important, tyache 10 points ahet that we have to discuss first, then नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर वी कैन से ग्लोबलाइजेशन मधले की कंटेक्स्ट कुठले आहेत ज्याच्यासाठी ग्लोबलाइजेशन इम्पॉर्टंट आहे ते दोन पॉइंट आहेत सॉरी व्हाट आर द की कंटेक्स्ट फॉर विच दिस बिझनेस इथिक्स इज इम्पॉर्टंट सो दॅट टू की कंटेक्स्ट वी हॅव टू डिस्कस दॅट इज ग्लोबलायझेशन अँड सस्टेनेबिलिटी आणि तिसरा पॉइंट आहे इथिकल थेअरीज मग इथिकल थेअरीज मध्ये कुठले दोन टाइप्स आहेत नॉर्मेटिव्ह आणि डिस्क्रिप्टिव्ह त्या दोन इथिकल थेअरीज आपल्याला स्टडी करायचे ओके सो दिस इज द जनरल क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ दिस चॅप्टर वी कॅन से नाव वी विल स्टार्ट विथ द फर्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ दिस बिझनेस इथिक्स आता पहिला पॉइंट आहे एन ओव्हरव्ह्यू ऑफ बिझनेस इथिक्स इन चॅप्टर नंबर वन द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज ओव्हरव्ह्यू ऑफ बिझनेस इथिक्स नाव लॉट ऑफ डिस्कशन वी हॅव मेड ऑन दिस पर्टिक्युलर पॉइंट बट स्टील वी विल हॅव सम मोर पॉइंट्स फॉर डिस्कशन फॉर दिस बिझनेस इथिक्स सो वॉट इज गिवन हिअर बिझनेस इथिक्स one basic definition we have seen that is study or that is set of the moral values and ethical values which are required to be followed by the various stakeholders or we can say by all the people who are involved in the particular business that definition we have seen then another points in the overview are business ethics is the study of business situations activities and decisions where issues are right and where issues of right and wrong are addressed so it is also having the study of various situations in the business and in that particular situations what decision should be taken that is the one concept of business ethics it is the study of various business situations second business ethics is concerned with the study of morality and the application of reasons to a specific situation then business ethics refers to the set of moral values or standards which govern the activities of the business so that is the set of moral values and standards that already we have discussed business ethics practices norms and principles that guide the owners and managers in day to day life business decisions suppose a situation comes that where it is difficult for the particular businessman to take the decision then this business ethics document it can act as a guideline and last point here it is business ethics is thus a set of professional standard which emphasize principles of honesty and duty to the business and the general public so it is main focusing on the policy of honesty and performing the duty of every element properly okay so that is the few more points related to business ethics are you clear with this overview actually these are very basic points there will not be any question based on this but just for your understanding these points we have to discuss first the business ethics madhe vegvegla situation cha study asto vegvegla activities cha study asto where the decision taking is difficult that situations need to be addressed in business ethics again it is concerned with study of morality and its applications for specific rules and principles that determine what is wrong and right in the particular situation and these rules and principles are called as the ethical theories jasa apan sangitla ki ethical theories je ahet that is the baseline to form this business ethics document then business ethics refers to the set of moral values and standards again it consists of practices norms and principles that guide the owner and manager in day to day business decisions so all these points we have seen it is more focusing on principle of honesty and how the duty of every stakeholder should be performed properly okay so that is the overview of this business ethics again business ethics is more than just a concept used to enhance the image of the corporation ethics are the very foundation of success business ethics should be applied from the moment of first firm open its door. So means it is not the case that one company has been established and after its development, the business ethics document, it is formed or the business ethics are required to be followed. So from the start of the business itself, whoever are the elements of the business, they are required to follow the business ethics policies. So that is about the overview of business ethics. Lot of discussion we have done. Now here, the next very important and interesting point, it is importance of business ethics. आता आपण जनरली बरंच डिस्कशन केलंय की बिझनेस इथिक्स का इम्पॉर्टंट आहे, पण ह्या पर्टिक्युलर पॉइंट मध्ये बाय कन्सिडरिंग द पर्स्पेक्टिव्ह ऑफ व्हेरियस एलिमेंट्स इन्वॉल्व्ड इन द बिझनेस इथिक्स, वी हॅव टू डिस्क्राइब इम्पॉर्टन्स ऑफ बिझनेस इथिक्स. सो यू टेल मी फॉर एक्झाम्पल, आता बघा इथं आपल्याला 10 पॉइंटच्या रिस्पेक्टने बिझनेस इथिक्सचा इम्पॉर्टन्स डिस्क्राइब करायचा आहे. सो बेस्ड ऑन दिस पॉइंट there the question can be asked in the exam as explain the importance of business ethics. So kashasathi business ethics important ahe, for example itha pahila jo point dilela ahe that point I will explain first. So first point to describe importance of business ethics is consumer movement. Now what is the meaning of consumer? इथं काय दिलेलं आहे, कंज्युमर मुवमेंट साठी हा बिझनेस इथिक्स इम्पॉर्टंट आहे. सो यू टेल मी फर्स्ट व्हॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कंज्युमर. कंज्युमर मीन्स व्हॉट?
ग्राहक.
ओके, ग्राहक द पर्सन हु इज गोइंग टू परचेस द पर्टिक्युलर प्रोडक्ट फ्रॉम युअर बिझनेस, दॅट इज द कंज्युमर. कंज्युमर मुवमेंट हा पहिला पॉइंट आहे इम्पॉर्टन्स ऑफ बिझनेस इथिक्स मधला. सो व्हॉट एक्सप्लेनेशन इज गिव्हन हियर, बिझनेस इथिक्स आर गेनिंग इम्पॉर्टन्स बिकॉज ऑफ द ग्रोथ ऑफ द कंज्युमर मुवमेंट. टुडेज कंज्युमर आर अवेअर ऑफ देअर राईट. सो एज नाउ द पीपल आर मोर लिटरेट, दे आर अवेअर अबाउट देअर राईट. एखाद्या बिझनेस मध्ये जर त्यांची फसवणूक झाली तरी एज अ citizen what that rights they are having, everybody is aware about their right against the any wrong transaction in any business. Ekada business madhe apli fasavnuk zali, purvi kasa hota ki we know that various examples in rural areas paryas vela literacy nasliamule lokanchi fasavnuk keli jayche business madhe, but that is not the case in today's situation. So whoever are the consumers, they are very literate, they are alert about their right, and because of this consumer movement, samjha ekada varti kai anyay zala tya business madhe kiwa ekadi chukicha product quality nasleda tyala send zala tar immediately that complaint it is made. So nowadays because of this online platform, it is very easy to directly complain to the main owner also. आपण डायरेक्टली मेल करू शकतो फॉर एनी कंप्लेंट रिलेटेड टू एनी प्रोडक्ट ऑर इट्स सर्व्हिसेस. दॅट्स वाय ह्या कंझ्युमर मुवमेंटमुळे बिझनेस इथिक्स इम्पॉर्टंट आहे. दॅट इज फर्स्ट पॉइंट. यू टेल मी अदर रिझन्स कुणाकुणाच्या पर्स्पेक्टिव्हने बिझनेस इथिक्स इम्पॉर्टंट असणार आहे, आपण बघणारच आहे ते पॉइंट वन बाय वन. जस्ट आय वॉन्ट टू टेक युअर व्ह्यूज. एक पॉइंट मी तुम्हाला आता सांगितला की बिझनेस इथिक्स इज important because of consumer movement. Immediately they are taking some actions, they are making complaints. That is one point ki ha consumer movement mule business ethics important hai. You think and tell me what are other points because of which the business ethics can be important. Yes, try to give the answers. Kay asu shaktat ajun points jyacha sathi business ethics important ahe. Yes, be interactive in the lecture. Yes, Audumbar. What can be the points other points for understanding importance of business ethics. Yes. Audumbar, are you there in the lecture?
Yes, I'm there.
Are you getting my question?
Yes, ma'am.
Then try to give some answer. Let it be wrong. आता काय पॉइंट एक्सप्लेन केला मी तो कळला तुम्हाला. कंज्युमर मुवमेंट म्हणजे काय?
ग्राहक.
कंज्युमर मुवमेंट मीन्स एज द कंज्युमर इज अलर्ट, दे आर लिटरेट, दे आर व्हेरी अटेंटिव्ह अबाउट देअर राईट्स. सो इफ एनी काइंड ऑफ रॉंग थिंग हॅपन विथ देम, फॉर एक्झाम्पल एखादा प्रोडक्ट त्यांना ऑनलाईन तुम्ही सेंड केला, त्याच्यामध्ये जर काही क्वालिटी त्यांना खराब वाटली किंवा त्याची जर सर्व्हिस त्यांना वेळेवर मिळाली नाही तर इमिजिएटली दे आर कंप्लेनिंग अबाउट दॅट. सो दॅट ऑल दिस थिंग्स आर कॉल्ड एज ऍक्शन टेकन बाय द कंज्युमर आफ्टर गेटिंग एनी रॉंग थिंग इन द बिझनेस, दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज कंज्युमर मुवमेंट. मग ही कंज्युमर मुवमेंट मुळे बिझनेस इथिक्स इम्पॉर्टंट आहे, हा पहिला पॉईंट झाला. तसेच अजून कुठले पॉइंट आहेत? आता हे कंज्युमर पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू ने झालं, अजून कुणाच्या पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू ने बिझनेस इथिक्स इम्पॉर्टंट आहे तुम्ही सांगा मला. दिस इज फ्रॉम कंज्युमर्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू. अजून कुठले कुठले स्टेक होल्डर्स इन्वॉल्व्ह असतात बिझनेसमध्ये? आता फक्त गिरायकालाच असतं का बिझनेस इथिक्स इम्पॉर्टंट? इट इज वेदर इट इज
जे डिलिव्हरी करतात त्यांना पण.
हा, फॉर एक्झाम्पल फॉर द ओनर ऑफ द बिझनेस, म्हणजे आपण बिझनेसमन म्हणू शकतो, बिझनेसमनला सुद्धा. सो फॉर एक्झाम्पल, सिम्पल एक्झाम्पल आय विल गिव्ह. बरेचदा आपण वॉरंटी हा कन्सेप्ट बघतो, ऑल ऑफ अस नो दॅट व्हॉट इज गॅरंटी वॉरंटी. सो वाय दिस टर्म्स आर अगेन डिफाइन्ड? सपोज वॉरंटी इज देअर आफ्टर वन इयर, आफ्टर वन इयर the businessman or whoever are the seller, they are not taking any responsibility. So that is safe from that businessman's point of view. So business ethics is not to make only consumer safe, but it is also to make the businessman also safe in his particular business, with the condition that he is following all the ethical rules, or he is following all the moral principles. So with respect to that, there are various points to explain this importance of business ethics. We will see it one by one. Pahila point apan bagitla consumer movement. I hope everyone is clear with this consumer movement point. So same it is continued here. Consumer, they can take action against those businessmen who create in bad business ethics practices, or those who are making some bad business ethics practices. Kutle asu shaktat bad business ethics practices? Poor quality of the product, harmful product, high price, high profile priced product, and duplicate goods. Ata kadhi kadhi original price vegri aste MRP chi, ani ti price tyachyavarti dusra tag lavlela asto barach vela, the person who are selling that particular product. These all are coming as the bad practices. These are also called as the malpractices also. That's why the only way to survive in business is to be honest and fair. Because immediately the action is taken by the consumer. So to avoid this, the business ethics is important. That is first point. Are you clear with the first point? Yes. Are you clear with the first point, Audumbar?
One second, ma'am. Repeat karta ka?
Pahila point repeat karayacha ka?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Bara, ta kutla point baghtoy apan te samajla ka tumhala? Which main point we are discussing? Which chapter is going on right now?
Yes, ma'am. First chapter.
First chapter. त्यातला एक पॉइंट आहे इम्पॉर्टन्स ऑफ बिझनेस एथिक्स. ओके, सो इफ यू सी द सिलेबस ऑफ द फर्स्ट चॅप्टर, दिस इज सेकंड पॉइंट, इम्पॉर्टन्स ऑफ बिझनेस इथिक्स. हा पॉइंट आपण डिस्कस करतोय, इम्पॉर्टन्स ऑफ बिझनेस इथिक्स. मग बिझनेस इथिक्सचा इम्पॉर्टंट हा 10 वेगवेगळ्या पॉइंटच्या पर्स्पेक्टिव्ह कन्सिडर करून आपण बघतोय. मग त्यातला पहिला पॉइंट कुठला आहे, कंझ्युमर मुवमेंट. कंझ्युमर मुवमेंट म्हणजे काय, आता एखाद्या कंझ्युमरला एखादं प्रोडक्ट बिझनेसमॅनने विकलं, सपोज, अँड दॅट बिझनेस इन दॅट पर्टिक्युलर प्रोसेस इफ एनी रॉंग ट्रीटमेंट इट इज गिव्हन टू द कंझ्युमर, किंवा कुठली तरी बॅड प्रॅक्टिस त्या बिझनेसमध्ये जर इम्प्लिमेंट झाली, फॉर एक्झाम्पल कुठल्या बॅड प्रॅक्टिसेस आहेत, चांगल्या क्वालिटीचा माल त्याला दिला गेला नाही कस्टमरला, इफ इट इज हार्मफुल ऑर हाय प्रोफाईल प्राइस्ड डुप्लिकेट गुड्स, म्हणजे एखादी किंमत त्याची ओरिजिनल कमी आहे पण ती बिझनेसमधनं जर जास्त वाढू लावली किंमत आणि तसा माल जर सेंड केला कंझ्युमरला, तर ह्या सगळ्या अशा सिच्युएशन आहेत की ज्याला आपण बॅड प्रॅक्टिसेस म्हणू शकतो, बॅड बिझनेस इथिक्स प्रॅक्टिसेस. मग अशी एखादी प्रॅक्टिस जर बिझनेसमननी त्या बिझनेसमध्ये केली तर व्हॉट कंझ्युमर कॅन डू इन दॅट केस, सपोज समथिंग हॅपन्स विथ यू, फॉर एक्झाम्पल एखादा ऑनलाईन प्रोडक्ट तुम्ही मागवलं आणि ते प्रॉपरली आलं नाही तुम्हाला, तर व्हॉट विल यू टेक इट ॲज इट इज, ॲज यू आर पेईंग मनी फॉर दॅट, तसंच प्रोडक्ट घेणार का तुम्ही जर खराब आलं ऑनलाईनमध्ये, ऑनलाईन तुम्ही ऑर्डर दिली आणि एखादं प्रोडक्ट खराब आलं, हा तर यू विल नॉट टेक इट ॲज इट इज, इमिजिएटली यू विल मेक सम कंप्लेंट ऑर यू विल रिटर्न इट इफ रिस्पॉन्स इज नॉट प्रॉपर इवन आफ्टर कंप्लेंट्स, यू विल टेक सम अनदर ॲक्शन. किंवा जर कधी कधी इफ दॅट पर्सन कंझ्युमर इज अवेअर अबाउट लॉज अँड एव्हरीथिंग, लिगल ॲक्शन ऑल्सो कॅन बी टेकन बाय द कंझ्युमर. मग ह्याला काय म्हणतात, कंझ्युमर मुवमेंट. एखादी बॅड प्रॅक्टिस बिझनेसमध्ये इम्प्लिमेंट झाल्यानंतर कंझ्युमर जी ॲक्शन घेतो त्याच्यावरती, दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज द बिझनेस सॉरी कंझ्युमर मुवमेंट. सो टू अवॉइड दिस कंझ्युमर मुवमेंट, दिस बिझनेस इथिक्स इज इम्पॉर्टंट, बिकॉज इफ द बिझनेस इथिक्स इज फॉलोड बाय द बिझनेसमॅन देन देअर इज नो एनी नीड for the consumer to take any action. Okay, so that is the first point. Are you clear now, Agambar?
Yes, now it's partially clear.
Clear or not?
Yes, all clear.
I am not getting what you are saying. Yes, others?
Yes, ma'am, all clear.
ओके, नाव द सेकंड पॉइंट इज, आता फक्त मुवमेंट वी शुड नॉट कन्सिडर, बट अनदर पॉइंट वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर फ्रॉम कंझ्युमर पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू, दॅट इज कंझ्युमर सॅटिस्फॅक्शन. आता बऱ्याच वेळा लिहिलेलं असतो बोर्ड मॉलमध्ये दुकानामध्ये, दॅट कंझ्युमर्स सॅटिस्फॅक्शन इज अवर गोल, लाईक दॅट. सो अल्टिमेट एम ऑफ द बिझनेस इज not only to get profit, but along with that the consumer should be also satisfied with this product. So another importance of business ethics is consumer satisfaction. Today's consumer is the king of the market. Any business simply cannot survive without the consumer. So if consumers are not there, there will not be any business. That's why the main aim or objective of business is consumer's satisfaction. And when the consumer will be satisfied, consumer will be satisfied only if the businessman follows all the business ethics and hence are highly needed. The business ethics properly follow hota sel businessman kadun, then and then only the business that consumer it is satisfied. So for that consumer satisfaction, the business ethics is important. That is the description for this second point. Okay, so first and two, second point, consumer movement and consumer satisfaction. The only points related ahead, and they are related with the consumer's point of view, or they are with respect to consumer's perspective. The first point is the importance of business ethics. स्टॉप बिझनेस माल प्रॅक्टिसेस. माल प्रॅक्टिसेस म्हणजे काय? स्टॉप बिझनेस माल प्रॅक्टिसेस. माल प्रॅक्टिसेस मीन्स व्हॉट? बॅड प्रॅक्टिसेस. सो अर्थ समजून घ्या ह्या शब्दाचा. माल प्रॅक्टिसेस म्हणजे बॅड प्रॅक्टिसेस विच आर कॅरीड आउट ड्युरिंग द बिझनेस. सम बिझनेसमॅन डू बिझनेस माल प्रॅक्टिसेस बाय इंडल्जिंग इन अनफेअर ट्रेड प्रॅक्टिसेस. लाईक व्हॉट आर दॅट अनफेअर प्रॅक्टिसेस? ब्लॅक अँड व्हाईट मार्केटिंग, आर्टिफिशियल हाय प्रायसिंग. जसं मी सांगितलं तुम्हाला की ओरिजिनल प्राइस वरती दुसरं लेबल लावायचं आणि तिथं त्याची प्राइस त्या प्रोडक्टची वाढवून द्यायची. दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज आर्टिफिशियल हाय प्राइसिंग. देन ॲडल्ट्रेशन, चिटिंग इन वेट अँड मेजर. सो दॅट इज युजली हॅपनिंग. सो ऑल ऑफ यू माइट बी नोईंग दॅट. सो इन मेनी ऑफ द रुरल एरियाज जो वजन काट असतो, सम अनदर थिंग इट इज अटॅच ऍडिशनली टू दॅट, सो दॅट ऍक्च्युअल जे त्या मालाचं वजन आहे ते वजन काय होतं? कमी होतं. ओके, सो दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज द चिटिंग इन वेट अँड मेजर्स. सेलिंग ऑफ डुप्लिकेट अँड हार्मफुल प्रोडक्ट्स इन्स्टेड ऑफ ओरिजिनल. Duplicate and harmful products can be said. That these all are the malpractices in the business. And obviously that malpractices are harmful for the businessman. And along with that, they are also harmful for the consumers. काही केसेस मध्ये जर एखाद्या ओरिजिनल प्रोडक्टच्या ऐवजी हार्मफुल डुप्लिकेट प्रोडक्ट तिथं सेंड केला गेला तर त्याचा काय होतो? What can be its effect? That particular that product, it is harmful for the consumer. Okay, so that's why this all, to stop all these business malpractices, this business ethics, it is required. That is the third point. Then the fourth point, it is to improve the consumer's confidence. So how the consumer's confidence is increased? Business ethics is required to improve the consumer's confidence about the quality, quantity, price, etc. of the product. The customers have more trust and confidence in the businessman who follows the ethical rule, and they feel that such businessman will not cheat them. So that is very simple thing which we will observe in our डे टू डे लाईफ. जेव्हा आपण कुठल्याही कुठल्याही गोष्टी परचेस करतो, आपलं साधं आपल्या घरातलं रोजचं सामान असू द्या, लेट इट बी क्लॉथ्स ऑर किंवा वेन एव्हर इट कम्स टू द परचेस ऑफ गोल्ड ऑल्सो, आपण एक ठराविक दुकानदाराकडूनच घेतो त्या गोष्टी. व्हाय दॅट हॅपन्स? बिकॉज वी हॅव कॉन्फिडन्स ऑन दॅट बिझनेसमन. हा, दॅट पर्टिक्युलर बिझनेसमन विल नॉट चीट अस. तिथं मिळणारा प्रोडक्ट आपल्याला चांगल्या क्वालिटीचं मिळेल किंवा तिथं आपली फसवणूक होणार नाही, हा जो विश्वास असतो कस्टमरचा, तर तो कधी इम्प्रूव्ह होतो? फॉर एक्झाम्पल, एखाद्याने तुम्हाला कधीतरी फसवलं एखाद्या बिझनेसमध्ये, एखाद्या किंवा एखादा प्रोडक्ट तुम्हाला तिथलं चांगलं लागलं नाही, तर परत तुम्ही जाता का त्या दुकानात फॉर परचेसिंग एनी अदर थिंग ऑल्सो? You are not going, because there you don't have confidence that you will get the good quality product there. Kiwa tumhala asa confidence nasto ki tumchi fasavnuk tithe honar nahi. Tyamule this customer's confidence is important, and when it will be improved, when the customer will know that you are following the business ethics. That's why this business ethics is important. Then fifth important point is survival of business. Business ekada vyavasthitpane chalu rahnyasathi sudha business ethics important hai. Okay, so how it takes place? Suppose ekada business chalu jalay, initially even after having some malpractices, you may run your business, you may sell the product, but after that suppose after 2 months, 3 months, whatever is your original thing, if it comes in picture, then after that it will not be, or the business will not be able to run properly. Tamula, for survival of business, this business ethics is very important. आता काही कंपन्या असतात बऱ्याचदा की सुरुवातीला त्याचे प्रोडक्ट च खूप विक्री होती, बट आफ्टर दॅट इमिजिएटली कस्टमर्स कम टू नो दॅट देअर इज सम फ्रॉड ऑर देअर इज सम वॉट वी कॅन से बॅड प्रॅक्टिस इज फॉलोड देअर अँड आफ्टर दॅट देअर दॅट पर्टिक्युलर बिझनेस इट इज इमिजिएटली स्टॉप. त्यामुळं टेम्पररी तो बिझनेस रन होऊ शकतो, बट फॉर सर्वायवल मीन्स फॉर रनिंग द बिझनेस फॉर लॉंग टाइम दॅट business ethics is required. So business ethics is mandatory for survival of business. The businessman who don't follow it will have the short term success, but they will fail in the long run of this business because they cannot cheat the they can cheat the consumer only once. After that the consumer will not buy goods or any products from the businessman, and this will result in the failure of the businessman. Okay, so for if the businessman doesn't follow the ethical rule, he will fail in the market. That these are the first 5 points. So are you clear with this first 5 points? Yes, give the answer, give the consent.
Yes.
Oh. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So next point is importance of labor. So labor means not exactly from that original meaning, but along with labor, if there are employees also we have to consider. Employee point of view ne kiwa labor point of view ne ha ek baghitla apan atta paryanta kutla points of view ne baghitle importance pehla hota consumer cha. Consumers movement, consumer satisfaction, stop business malpractices, consumers confidence, survival of business. आता एखाद्या business मध्ये जसा businessman असतो consumer असतो तसा third important stakeholder कोण येतो business मध्ये? Labor or employees who are working in the company for producing that particular products. So labor, that is employees or workers, they play very crucial role in the success of the business. That's why business must be, or therefore businessman must follow the business ethics while dealing with the employees. Okay, so that business ethics is having important element of as employee working in the particular business. That's why the businessman cannot treat in any wrong way with the employees. That is the another point for importance of business ethics from point of view of employees or labor. The businessman must give them proper wages and salaries and provide them with better working condition. Whatever is the working condition, it jar ekadi safety follow hot nasel, ha kai instrument madhe earthing properly nasel, shock tya case madhe basun एम्प्लॉईला काहीतरी दुखापत होऊ शकते त्या केसमध्ये. हा सो ऑल दीज आर द केअर्स दॅट शुड बी टेकन बाय द बिझनेसमन बाय कन्सिडरिंग द एम्प्लॉईज सिक्युरिटी अँड सेफ्टी. दॅट इज वन पॉइंट, दॅट इज द मिनिंग ऑफ दिस, दॅट बाय प्रोव्हाइडिंग देम विथ बेटर वर्किंग कंडिशन. वर्किंग कंडिशन शुड बी प्रॉपर, देअर मस्ट बी गुड रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द एम्प्लॉयर अँड द एम्प्लॉईज. एम्प्लॉयर म्हणजे मालक जो एम्प्लॉईला जॉब देतो तो, आणि एम्प्लॉय मीन्स द पर्सन हु इज वर्किंग. सो देअर शुड बी प्रॉपर रिलेशन मेंटेन विथ द एम्प्लॉई अँड द एम्प्लॉयर्स, अँड द एम्प्लॉईज मस्ट ऑल्सो बी गिव्हन प्रॉपर वेलफेअर फॅसिलिटीज. वॉट एव्हर फॅसिलिटीज आर देअर टू बी एक्सपेक्टेड फॉर दॅट एम्प्लॉईज, दॅट फॅसिलिटीज शुड बी प्रॉपरली गिव्हन. बऱ्याचदा इंडस्ट्रीमध्ये आपण बघतो की ऑन ड्युटी असताना जर एखाद्याला दुखापत झाली किंवा त्याचा ऍक्सिडेंट झाला तर होल दॅट एक्सपेन्सेस आर कॅरीड आउट बाय दॅट पर्टिक्युलर कंपनी ओनली. दॅट इज द वेल वन ऑफ द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ वेलफेअर फॅसिलिटी. इवन मेनी फॅसिलिटीज आर प्रोव्हाइडेड बाय द एमएनसी कंपनीज अँड आय टी कंपनीज. सो दॅट मीन्स दे आर टेकिंग केअर, So even in IT companies, many times that women are working and they are having small kids. So there is some facility where, in the company itself where they can keep their child also. Like this, from employee satisfaction point of view, the various welfare facilities should be given to the employees. That is the third, that is sixth point, importance of labor or importance of the employees. Then next is healthy competition. So when the businesses are there, obviously always there are competitors for any business. The business must, or the businessman must use business ethics while dealing with the competitor. आता एखादा कॉम्पिटिटर आहे म्हणून त्याच्याशी वागताना सुद्धा तुम्ही बिझनेस एथिक्स फॉलो करून ट्रीट केलं पाहिजे. दे मस्ट हॅव हेल्दी कॉम्पिटिशन विथ द कॉम्पिटिटर्स अँड व्हाईल डुईंग दिस कॉम्पिटिशन ऑल्सो दॅट इथिकल व्हॅल्यू शुड बी प्रॉपरली मेंटेन. सिमिलरली दे मस्ट गिव इक्वल अपॉर्च्युनिटीज टू स्मॉल स्केल बिझनेस. दे मस्ट अवॉइड मोनोपॉली. दिस इज बिकॉज मोनोपॉली इज हार्मफुल टू द कंझ्युमर्स. तर ह्या कॉम्पिटिशन मध्ये एकमेकांशी कम्पीट करत असताना व्हॉट एव्हर आर द डिफरंट कंपनीज दे आर कॉम्पिटिटर्स ऑफ इच अदर, बट स्टील व्हाईल डुईंग द कॉम्पिटिशन यू शुड फोकस ऑन इन्क्रीजिंग द युअर प्रोडक्ट किंवा त्याच्यामध्ये चांगलं मटेरियल वापरून सुद्धा तुम्ही कशा पद्धतीने त्याची प्राइस कमी करू शकता. दॅट पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू यू शुड थिंक. सो you should not think for any wrong thing or harmful, doing harmful thing to your competitor or like that. That is called as the healthy competition, and there should not be any monopoly in the business. So equal right should be given to the every businessman. So that for this healthy competition also business ethics is important. Next point is create good image. Good image kunachi? To create the good image of the business and as of the businessman. So business ethics create good image of the business and businessman. If the businessman follows all ethical rules, then they will be fully accepted and not criticized by the society. So to have the good image in the society, it is must that you should follow the business ethics, and the society will always support those businessmen who follow this necessary code of conduct. Code of conduct manje kay? That is one document which describes how that particular element of the company should behave. Mag ta code of conduct la anusarun jar ekada businessman vagat asel, then definitely image of that businessman it is good. And here the next point is smooth functioning. जर बिझनेस मधल्या सगळ्या एलिमेंट्सनी त्यांचे त्यांचे रूल प्रॉपरली फॉलो केले, फॉर एक्झाम्पल इफ द बिझनेस इथिक्स फॉलोज ऑल द बिझनेस इथिक्स, देन द एम्प्लॉईज, शेअर होल्डर्स, कंझ्युमर्स, डीलर्स, सप्लायर्स ऑल विल बी हॅपी अँड देअर विल बी स्मूथ फंक्शनिंग ऑफ द पर्टिक्युलर बिझनेस. सो फॉर दिस द बिझनेस इथिक्स इज इम्पॉर्टंट. सो टू पॉइंट्स आर रिमेनिंग, दॅट आर प्रोटेक्टिंग एम्प्लॉईज अँड डेव्हलपिंग द गुड relations. Okay, so that we will discuss in the next lecture. So we will stop here. Whether the points are clear to you, whatever we have discussed today? Yes, Shreya?
Yes, I'm clear.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Any other student? You can give answer by your own. Very simple things are there. Try to understand it and attend the lectures regularly so that the flow will be maintained. Okay, so you just type your number in the chat box and you can leave the meeting. Okay.